And you can get a free introductory copy, either hard copy or a email copy.
Excellent. I want to shift gears and really discuss how the public is being more and more acclimated to military and military-style troops on the street. You know, I went down and I covered the G20 in Pittsburgh with another couple info warriors here in the office, and they locked down the entire downtown area of Pittsburgh with Humvees and National Guard units at every bridge, at every street corner. And when I went up to them and I was filming them, sometimes with Cindy Sheehan, who would approach them and say, you know, my son died for this. This is disturbing. This is disgusting. And I would ask them, you know, what do you have to say to critics that would say that this is a violation of posse comitatus? And I was talking to, you know, people who were the freshest in the military, 18-year-old kids, to people who were 40 and 50 years old, sometimes even older than that, who had, you know, all sorts of military experience, and not one of them could even tell me what that was, Bob.
Well, that's understandable. Among the ranks, unfortunately, you don't get a lot of high IQs. And so these people, you know, they do their job, which is to function as an arm of the United States government and the president. And they don't know very much about anything. You will occasionally find people in certain units that do, but more often than not, no. And the officerial corps, of course, if you address them, they might have smiled and said, well, I'd rather not speak about that, but I understand what you're talking about. And so they just don't know. But on the other hand, Jason, we're looking at half the population in America is functionally illiterate. And so, you know, you can't expect probably more than one-third to even have a wild idea of what you're talking about.
So sad. It really, really is.
And every country's in the same boat. They all have functional illiteracy that's terrible. And I'm talking, you know, ours is about 51%. Canada's is 40%. I mean, Germany's is 40%. The educational systems in all these countries have degenerated unbelievably.
Well, we see it when we, you know, talk to people, and they can't tell us what the three branches of government are, but they can tell us about David Letterman's affair. You know, we are so mesmerized and hypnotized by the box that talks to us at night in our living rooms that we just don't seem to take an interest in what's going on in the streets of our own country. And, you know, out of the Washington Times today, DHS is deploying LRAD weapons to police departments around the country, again, furthering the militarization of our police force, Bob.
I saw the article, and it's there. I carry it in tomorrow's International Forecaster, which keeps on getting bigger and bigger. In fact, I carry more links now than I ever did before because there's so much going on out there, and I don't want to miss anything. And I know everybody doesn't have the time to read the whole thing each time it comes, but that's okay. Go through and pick out what appeals to you and things that you see that you want to know about.
Absolutely. All right, so they're now admitting that the jobless rate is at 9.8%. What do you think the true and real numbers are at this point?
Well, all you have to do is take U6, which is 16.8%, the last figure I got. And that includes that short-term unemployment you just mentioned and all the people who are no longer getting state checks for unemployment, all the people who are working part-time, which is almost 10 million people. The average work week now is 33.1 hours at the last time I saw it. And also we have the discouraged people who have gone out and for a year and a half or two are trying to get a job and there just isn't any. And so they've just given up. So that's what comprises that 16.8% U6. But there's another thing in there called the birth-death ratio. And it was something created in 2003. And the government said, we don't have time to go out and check on all those small and medium-sized companies, so we're going to guess at it. Well, of course, they always guess in their own direction. And they average about creating about 185,000 jobs a month. And that's on average. And so if you take that out of U6, because it's a Mickey Mouse figure, it's 21% unemployment.
That's one in every five people in this country with no job. Unbelievable.
It's going to get a lot worse.
Yeah, we continue to slide down this path of establishment tyranny, of mindlessness, of everything's going to be okay. Everything's not going to be okay unless we step up to the plate and hold our leaders accountable and try to bring the Constitution and Bill of Rights back from the brink of extinction. We'll be back after this. It's the Alex Jones Show. I'm Jason Burma sitting in. PrisonPlanet.tv, Infowars.com. The Alex Jones Show. I'm Jason Burmes sitting in. Peter Dale Scott coming up in the next segment in studio. We're sitting here with Bob Chapman. Mr. Chapman, in this final segment, why don't you just wrap up in a nutshell, what is the most important thing that the American populace needs to know at this point?
I think they know, should know, and they should get after their senators and congressmen and make sure we passed H.R. 1207 and investigate and audit the Federal Reserve and then ultimately get rid of it. It's the nexus of the Illuminati. This is the core of which they operate from. And if we can separate that and get rid of it, we can move towards solving some of the problems. There's a big move afoot right now to, as I said earlier in the program, to replace the dollar. There's no question now. People, in order to protect themselves, have to be in gold and silver-related assets. What's going to happen next year? Half of the stimulus package has been spent. And my guess is most of it will be gone into the economy by next June. So the second half of next year will see the remainder of the effect. And after that, if they don't inject another $2 trillion stimulus into the economy, or banks can increase their lending, which is off about 14% from last year. If both of them don't do that, the economy is going to spiral into a deflationary mode. Now, what do I think is going to happen? I think we're going to get another stimulus package, and I predicted that last January because I did all the numbers, and I said this isn't going to work for them. And so that's where we're headed with these things. Getting rid of the Federal Reserve is the number one thing we can do. And besides that, we should get as many people as we can to listen to Alex's show so they'll understand what's going on fresh, right to the moment. And, of course, my publication, which follows it up a couple of days later. And for those who can't see that, they can read. Anyway, those are the most important things.
What do you think about this word that the FDIC is asking for a bailout? I saw that a couple weeks ago, and I'd just forgotten to cover it. I mean, what happens if the FDIC gets a bailout?
Well, first of all, they're broke. Mm-hmm. They've asked the banks for a increase of dues for over the next 2 years to get it now. I don't think that's doable. And they're going to have to go to the government for $500 billion. And they'll be subsidized just like Fannie, Freddie, Ginny, FHA, and all of these other agencies. And just to put that line of all the deposits under $250,000 to cover 1% of those deposits, which are supposedly insured, will cost $700 billion. So let's say that the U.S. government gave them $700 billion. I mean, they're going to be, that's 1% of what they need. I mean, half the banks in this country are going to go down. There's 8,400 approximately. Between 3,200 and 4,200 are going down.
Bob Chapman of the InternationalForecaster.com. I mean, if you're listening, folks, it's time to take action. Any word when this will hit the Senate? We know that 1207 has passed through Congress. When is it up for the Senate?
Well, I think it's up to the Senate itself, and we need some great support there. The last I saw, we had 23 co-sponsors. We need everybody to contact every senator and just say, we want you to pass SB 604, I think it is, and we want that to get passed, and I think you'll do a great deal of good by doing that because they do listen.
Bob Chapman, thank you so much for joining us. It's the Alex Jones Show. Peter Dale Scott in studio in just a moment. I'm Jason Burma sitting in. Go check us out at Infowars.com, and we're streaming live at PrisonPlanet.tv.